then self-development, then sports and education. And today's project or event falls under the education avenue of ReAlumni Dombivli chapter. ReAlumni Trust Foundation is the parent entity. Then we have three chapters: ReAlumni Dombivli, ReAlumni Shahapur, and ReAlumni Vasan. And I feel really proud to also tell you that all the participants of this meeting today, who are 10 science students, would definitely be ReAlumni members of the future. And the guest speakers that we have today on board are also ReAlumni members, or we can say they are ex-students of Real Academy. So I'll just give a small introduction to all these people. Today's first guest I'm going to introduce is a very dear friend of mine, and he's also one of the founder members of ReAlumni. His name is Vasudev Vidyadhar Samant. He's a Master of Science in Structural Engineering from the University of Houston and is working as a bridge engineer in SDR Consensus US. Vasudev is a friend, almost a brother from another mother. And this guy is super talented. He has a number of other skills already honed to him. And apart from all the educational, professional achievements he has, he's always open to ideas and a very creative individual. The second guest today is a student of mine. And now, if you can say, he's more of a friend than a student. And I always make sure that all my students are my friends. His name is Maitreya Sunavne. He's an alumnus of Real Academy. He's currently a third year student at Arizona State University studying astrophysics at US. And apart from academics, he's also involved in some on-campus clubs like Astronomy Club and Greek Life. Let me also tell you, Maitreya Sunavne is an ex-student of Vidyaniketan school as well, and he scored roughly 97% or something in his 10th board examinations. That is almost my weight right now. Talking of Ritesh, the third guest, Ritesh Kakade. Ritesh and me, like batchmates, an IITian from IIT Bombay. He studied aerospace engineering there. He's currently working as assistant manager at Citigroup. And at Citigroup, he mainly does financial modeling. After his BTech from IIT Bombay in aerospace, he did master's in quantitative economics from Indian Statistical Institute, Delhi. And apart from being so qualified, we are left with the final guest, but yeah, one of the cutest guests we have today. His name is Harsh Agarwal. He's a final year MBBS student at Dr. D.Y. Patil Medical College. He's presented a poster in bioethics conference at Amritsar in front of Dr. Rizal D'Souza, who's chairperson South Asia UNESCO World. He's presented a paper on hunger at ABVP Chennai. He's presented a paper on malnutrition in Kolhapur children below 5 years. He's completed government authorized workshop on emergency medicine and surgical skills. He's a council member of bioethics chair of UNESCO. He's won second prize in debate on doctor patient relationship. He's won first prize in group debate on enthusiasm. He took part in government survey of Kolhapur floods by district magistrate. And he's his first class in first year as well as third year MBBS academic exam. So I guess that's a very heavy panel today that we already have. And on that note, I would turn my video on so that all my friends can see me after long. On what grounds should a student select his engineering stream? And I guess that question goes to none other than Vasudev Samant, who's done his engineering in civil from India and has completed master's from US. What do you think, Vasudev? How can a student go for selecting his engineering stream?
Hi, first of all, hi, good morning, everyone. And to answer your question, I would say, first of all, that की जर 10वी मध्ये तुम्हाला 90% वरती मार्क्स मिळतात तर 100% इंजिनिअरिंग सिलेक्ट केलं पाहिजे ऍज पर इंडियन पॅरेंट्स ऑर समथिंग लाईक दॅट. बट या सो टू आन्सर दिस क्वेश्चन आय वुड से इज सो हाऊ डीड आय सिलेक्ट माय इंजिनिअरिंग इज आय डिडंट नो आफ्टर 10th वॉट आय वॉज गोईंग टू डू. I mean, I had a picture in mind that I have to take science and I have to do something in the field of science, but I didn't know exactly how things are going to work out. What I would suggest is while choosing your engineering or while like picking any other career option in science field is make sure that you have interest in that field. So basically for me, I had an interest in physics as well as computer science. My coding was pretty good. I mean, not at this age of like, not when I was in 10th or something, but when around 12th, I had a pretty good coding background. So my logic, like coding logic was pretty good. And then also I had interest in physics. Now after 12th, what I was thinking is like where to go, like konsa engineering do. Either computer science lo, yeah, should I go for, like, I had two things in mind, like, should I go for some mechanical or civil thing? But my interests were pretty much lying in physics and mechanics of things, like how things works, how things happen or something like that. That's why I took engineering. So genuine interest in a particular field is important rather than, you know, having scoring good, just good marks and thinking that you would do better in engineering or you would do better in science. It's not just important, but the thing is genuine interest in science or genuine interest in physics is important while selecting any career option while you are choosing your career options or weighing your career options. That's what's important, because I have many of my friends who scored maybe 98%, 99%. I guess Kajal Soni, she scored 98% in her 10th standard, but she still went for commerce and she is now doing interior design and everything. She's opening up her startup as well. There are many streams, but yeah, while selecting any like streams like engineering or going for like astrophysics or aerospace engineering, it's more important to have, you know, genuine interest in, because it's not like a cakewalk, like you would just go and you have to give your efforts and you have to apply those, whatever the concepts you have learned over the years to engineering problems in when you actually go to work. That's why genuine interest is important. That's what I feel.
Okay, so we can sum up like this, ki you need to have a good physics and maths background, as well as you need to have hardcore interest to know or learn or explore about something, right? It's one particular thing.
Yes.
And
yes.
Then that particular thing, exactly. You go ahead with. Okay, fine. That's great. Vasudha, somehow your background looks like a pretty sunrise stuff. So that's great to see. What time is it in US right now?
If you want, I can change my background actually.
No. What time is it in US right now?
It's 2 a.m. Where 2 I live, it's 2 a.m. Where I guess okay. Maitreya live, it's I guess 1.
Okay.
11 p.m. Yeah, it's 11. It's 2.
What's really commendable is you guys have made it to this session at 2 a.m. and 1 a.m. in the night also. Thanks a lot for being here. We have more questions. The next question is, what are the international standards of Indian medical education? I guess that question goes to Harsh, Dr. Harsh Agarwal.
Yeah, first of all, okay. Very good morning to everyone. Happy lockdown to you guys. And so sir asked me the question for international standards. As far as the allopathy is concerned, every country has somewhat same medical curriculum, but since the infections and lifestyle differs, any country doesn't authorize the outside their country to practice modern medicine unless the candidates who are desiring to do so pass a licensing exam. So likewise, USMLE is conducted for USA, PLAB is conducted for UK, AMC for Australia. Similarly, India also conducts exams like a licensing exam for their foreign medical graduates. So yes, we can go abroad, as we said, but we need to give an exam. However, just to give an idea, many countries like Canada do not allow any doctor to practice in their country unless they are their citizen. So if you want to go for Canada, you have to apply for citizenship, which is not an easy task. And there are many other countries like Germany, China, Russia. For that, you have to have a good grip on the language. The language barrier is very much high. So for Germany, you have to go for the language degree, German language. So there are chances of getting good colleges or having good practice in other countries as well. But you have to go through the examination. So this is the answer.
Okay, what I heard is, and I don't know how true it is, you are from the field, you may know, it's quite easy to get a degree from Russia or other countries, but getting a reputed college and a good seat in a good institute in India is quite difficult, and hence the standard of Indian medical education across the globe is quite commendable or acceptable. Is that true? Like,
yeah,
our medical...
It is true, but here we get a degree in 5.5 years. And if we go in China, they start at least 6 years or 7 years. In US, it is 7 years. In UK also, it's too much. So first they teach language. China teaches language. Russia teaches language, Russian and Chinese. After that, they start with the medicine part. So it's time taking. Okay. Indian medicine is far more easy.
Okay. Fine. Is abroad medical education more financially draining as well?
No, it's comparatively cheaper if you go for the cheaper countries. Ukraine and Philippines are cheaper. China is cheaper. And India is costly if you are low with the grades.
China is out of the question. Or nothing from China. Okay. We'll go to the next question. Thank you. That was great, Harsh. The next question is, how different is bachelor's degree in science in US compared to that in India? So for that, I guess we have Maitreya here who's pursuing bachelor's in astrophysics already. Right, Maitreya?
Mm-hmm.
So put some light here.
No. Okay. Yeah, so I'll start by saying thank you so much for giving me an opportunity to talk on a platform like this. And I've never done anything like this before. So thank you so much. And I'll like to start by talking there are some differences that are you can see the differences. The major thing is any bachelor degree in the US is going to be of 4 years instead of 3 years in India. Like a bachelor of science in India is 3 years, but here it's already 4 years. Okay. And this does not make much of a difference in what you learn, but it's just spread out over 8 semesters. That's the main difference. But instead, in the quality of the learning and education, I would definitely say there's a greater emphasis on hands-on learning in the US as compared to India. So the labs that you have in the US are they need you to be more attentive or more involved in the process and the thought process and the thinking process that you put in problem solving and stuff. And this is not only specific for just science, but for almost every field, be it science related or commerce or arts, it doesn't matter. But and apart from that, there's one major thing that even if you're doing one specific field, you can also learn something about other fields also. Like one of my friends is doing electrical engineering, but he had 2 classes in a semester ago where he was learning economics and stock market and trading and stuff. So it's just you can learn valuable skill sets by not taking a degree in that subject, but you can also pursue them just as a hobby or you can use that skill set in the future.
Okay.
And yes, for me personally in astrophysics, I have more opportunities for internships and on-campus research under the professors that teach me. So this is one of the best opportunities that I'll get in the US. I don't think there's some place where I can research under professors while doing a bachelor's in India.
Okay. So we can sum up saying ki the one major difference which is quite visible is the 4 year term over there or the 8 semester thing. Second,
yeah,
you have exposure.
Quite financially draining because of that.
Okay. And you have exposure to learn other things apart from the bachelor of the core subject, as well as there are internship opportunities available at a grand scale, right?
Yes, exactly.
Okay, fine. Thank you, Maitreya. Thanks a lot. Moving on to the next question. The question is there any prerequisite to be an IITian? Is there a type of a student who makes it to IIT, or anyone can? Now, this is about getting into IIT, and none other than Ritesh Kakde will be able to answer this better. Prashna asa hai ki IITian honyasathi already kahi requirement aste ka vidyarthyacha kunta type asto ka ki koni IIT mein jau shakto. Okay. I'll be repeating questions in Marathi as well in between, because we have students from SEMI as well. Ha, Ritesh, over to you.
Hey, hi everyone. So good morning to all of you. So I think this question is very common one. So because the brand value that IIT has, it has created a perception that there's something different that you need to be for in order to get into IIT. But I think if in order to answer this question has an answer just similar to any question like how does a person become successful. So that's I think the three ingredients which anybody should have is one is the talent, and another is luck, and the third one is discipline. So you see, the talent and luck, you don't have it distributed well enough in the population. So the only thing that you can work on as an individual is a discipline. So if you are disciplined enough to do anything in life, I think you can achieve whatever you want to pursue. I mean, that is the moot point that I would like to make here for this particular question. So if you have a discipline, for instance, so preparing for IIT is quite draining in terms of the effort that you put, and in terms of the number of hours that you have to study, doing the same problems every time. You don't get it, then you have to again try it again and again in order to get it fully. So I think that requires a lot of discipline to make through to the IIT entrance exam. And in fact, this is not only true of IIT entrance exam. This is true of any entrance exam which is quite competitive. And as far as India is concerned, there are a lot of competitive exams. For instance, so after IIT, I also had to go through another competitive exam in order to do my master's in quantitative economics. So this applies to every exam and to every endeavor that you are going in, every domain that these things apply. So discipline is a very important thing that I think you must inculcate in yourself. And this is for the students who are currently in the 10th standard, this is, I think, a good opportunity to inculcate that discipline, which will help you a lot in life for everything.
Thanks. That's spot on, Ritesh. And believe me, I've never seen Ritesh speaking so much at a stretch. He's such a silent guy. Okay, Ritesh rightfully said we have to have a discipline. Like, we need to get into that phase of living wherein we align our habits, our time schedule, our lifestyle, our friends, and our entire thinking process in a way which directs it to preparation. Okay, aisa nahi bola ja raha hai ki aap dost mat banao, aap bahar mat jao, aap bahar ka khao mat, ghumo mat. Lekin कहीं ना कहीं आपकी चीजें प्रायोरिटाइज होनी चाहिए आपके एग्जाम को लेके, बिकॉज इट्स नॉट जोक व्हेन 15 लाख अदर स्टूडेंट्स आर अगेन फाइटिंग फॉर दैट सेम सीट. इट इज नॉट अ जोक. सो यू नीड टू हैव अ वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग डिसिप्लिन एंड डेडिकेशन इनसाइड यू. एंड एज फार एज आई नो रितेश, इवन ही वॉज नॉट अ स्टूडेंट हू हैड अपियर्ड फॉर लॉट ऑफ फाउंडेशन एग्जाम्स इन 8th, 9th, 10th और मेड इट थ्रू नेशनल लेवल मैथ साइंस एग्जामिनेशन. ही वॉज लाइक अ वेरी कॉमन डाउन टू अर्थ मॉडेस्ट हार्ड वर्किंग स्टूडेंट, राइट रितेश?
So I think you're right when you say, I don't know if I'm down to earth or not, but you're right when you say that I did not have any idea about IIT when I was in 9th standard, even in 10th standard. After I got a result to the 10th standard, I got to know about IIT from my different friends. They used to talk about IIT a lot, actually, because the only thing in my mind was engineering, not like that IIT. When I got to know about IIT, the type of institution it is, the brand value that it has, then only I got to know, and I faced a lot of problems also, because I was not from a background that had such a kind of upbringing where you can just go into you can just jump in and start preparing. So that was not my background. So discipline helped me a lot. So even if you have a talent but you're not disciplined enough, it doesn't work out, actually.
Okay. If I'm not wrong, your younger brother also has already made it through, and he's in US right now, right? Pursuing something.
No, So he actually made it through IIT, but he did not join actually. He did finally joined in Mohali. There's an institute called ICER, which is a pure science institute.
Okay.
Mathematics.
Great. So believe me, students, there's a like hell lot of discipline in this house, and I've been there and I know how does everything function. So if we say something, it's really worth following. Thank you, Ritesh. We'll go to the next question now. Next question is, at this stage, if students are in class 10, what should they do ideally to ensure a good engineering journey that goes to Vasudev? Davila je vidyarthi ahet, to tyanni nakki kay kele pahije atta pasun jene karun te ka changlya engineering cha path la journey la lagtil ani te 100% successfully complete kartil. Over to you, Vasu.
Okay, so for making it
Just interrupting you for a moment. Sorry.
Yeah.
Sorry. So I'll just also tell all my guests here ki all the students that are already here on this session, who are attending the session, they are a part of a FC program that we run, foundation course program that we run. Now this started in June and we are going to conduct it up to October. Every Sunday we have 3-hour sessions. And in those 3-hour sessions, we have teachers who are already teaching for IIT JEE for last 5-10 years, who are training these kids of 10th standard into advanced physics, advanced chemistry, advanced maths, and advanced biology, solving of MCQ, etc. So that is one initiative that already we are working on and students are a part of it. So I guess now Vasu will be able to connect it more.
Okay, so the thing is ki, if you are right now in standard 10 or even if you are starting for like getting into standard 11, the most thing you can do, it's like it's never too late. So what I think right now, like hamare time pe kaisa tha ki basically we had to give either CET to get into state colleges, and there was the other thing called AIEEE or JEE mains to get into IITs or NITs, whatever it was. So it was two different exams. Now they have combined it into one single exams, that is JEE mains. So at our time, CET was, compared to JEE, was relatively more easier. So students used to prefer to go to that instead of prepare, like students used to prepare for that and not the JEE mains. Like they used to target the state colleges. But right now, according to all the JEE mains and everything, the exam pattern has like the exam levels and the competition has went up basically. So what I would say is like Ritesh said, discipline is much and more like the important thing that you can apply to your lifestyle that you need to have while studying or while doing anything. And it's not like you have to have like a 24 hours program where you'll be sitting in front of a book and you'll be just solving some MCQs or just going through books to read about concepts and everything. Just learn things and then start preparing for those exams. The other thing you can do is like what I feel, mera ek dost tha jo matlab he went into IIT from our group, and what he used to do that I remember is, so he was prepared for all the MCQs, like all the subjects and everything when he was in 10th. Like he used to study the books of like one standard ahead of, like he was one standard literally ahead of us. And he used to bring like this fat book of mathematics or maybe physics or maybe chemistry or whatever it was. And he used to just start solving the MCQs, start learning the concepts while the teacher was actually teaching on the board. Now, I don't personally recommend or advocate not listening to your teachers while they are giving you the lectures, because
Sachin
ki baat bhi thodi sun leni chahiye. But the thing is, what I'm trying to suggest is, don't be like over smart or arrogant or whatever you call that person. He's not like that. But I'm just saying, don't be like that. But try to imbibe some of his, like I used to admire him and main waisa kabhi nahi kar paya. Like I couldn't even lift that fat book. But what you guys can do is try solving those MCQs, try getting into the concepts first, learn the books first instead of going to, you know, solve. Because what happens is aaj ye lecture padhne ke baad tum log ghar jaoge motivate hoke and you will start taking that MCQ book out or chalu kar doge. सॉल्व करना बेसिकली, बट यू वुडंट बी एबल टू सॉल्व मे बी वन और टू क्वेश्चन, और उससे डीमोटिवेट होके यू विल बी डन विद दैट. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ डूइंग दैट, प्रिपेयर फॉर द थिंग्स वेल, बी व्हाट आई कैन से लाइक बी हैव अ डिसिप्लिन्ड लाइफ, plan out whatever you want to do, like a schedule, like I have to do this, then this, then keep targets, like set targets, like this has to be done in this period of time, and then try to solve those MCQs or whatever, like preparing for the JEE mains and exams. That's what you can do to crack IIT or JEE mains exam or start preparing for IIT basically. And one more thing I would like to add is, at this stage, like at 10th, now it's not like अभी मैं ये बात बोलूँगा तो सचिन वापस मुझे मारेगा, लेकिन what I personally think is, so your 10th score is not really that important. Like I am working right now and nobody asked me what was your 10th score was. Or I haven't got a job based on my 10th score. Even though it was 92%, I haven't got a job based on that. So if at all it is possible, start learning, like start preparing yourself for a higher goal, like JEE mains or maybe 12th board exam, because that is more important. Because those concepts you are going to carry over in your engineering or your professional life. So that is more important. Start preparing for those. And instead of just learning, like going through your Marathi test book or your maths textbook in 10th, start reading those books so that you know what you are going to deal with when you are going to move ahead. That's what you also can do when you are in class 10th or class 9th or even in class 8th. That's totally fine.
Okay. So, to sum up that, I guess Vasu very nicely said, do not restrict yourself to the syllabus that is declared by the state government or whatever board you are for. You can always go for learning beyond that also. Do not restrict yourself to class learning only. Also, at the second instant, you said, do not jump onto MCQs directly because that will only demotivate you. So rather sharpen your skills well first. Okay. Refer books, ask doubts, practice them well, and then you can go on to it. And I'd like to also say here, defending the teacher perspective, like including me, Vasudev, Ritesh, Harsh, or Maitreya, or even Rajendra sir, we are all at a point where we are able to talk to the students, and none of us scored below 19-10 standard. Yeah, so what I'm trying to say here,
it's not important, but at
the same time, if you do good in your 10th standard, that will give a confidence to you, that will boost your confidence in you that, yes, I can do good things. I can, you know, outscore myself. And if I live like this, if I concentrate, if I focus, any exam can be a cakewalk to me, provided I don't, you know, get overconfident or I don't overestimate myself.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, I'm not saying ki tum log ekdam 60% score karo 10th standard mein and you will be setting a goal of 95% for 12th standard. It doesn't work like that. You have to have reasonable amount of score in your 10th standard as well. But it's not like you have to have 99% or 100%. It's not like
that. Okay. Thank you. Thanks, Vasudev. We'll go ahead with the next question. Can you please brief us about all the medical courses and the gateways to get into them? I guess that is about her, that is to Harsh, Dr. Harsh Agarwal. Harsh, what are all the medical courses in India and how do we get into them?
The courses depend on the medicine we want to learn. Like the person who want to become a dentist, go for BDS. The person who is interested in Ayurveda, goes for BAMS. Homeopathy interested people go for BHMS. Earlier it was called LCEH. Now it is called BHMS. Unani medicine is called BUMS. But you should know Urdu for it. Urdu script you should know. Then there is BNYS degree, which is naturopathy and yoga science ka degree. Then BPTH is physiotherapy, Bachelor of Physiotherapy. A lot of people are taking this degree because it gives you a good amount of money as well. And it has a lot of demand because after orthopedic surgery, a person has to go to a physiotherapist for his regular checkup and everything. just a minute, something happened. Yeah. So, and BSc nursing is done for training in nursing and paramedic staff. So all these except the BSc nursing gives you a doctorate degree in medical science. So okay. now for all these courses, there is one exam, NEET, National Eligibility Cum Entrance Test, which you have to give to get admission in these courses. And other than that, there is AIIMS for getting admission into AIIMS colleges all over Pan India. And JIPMER, for JIPMER College in Pondicherry. So there are courses for different medicines, and there is one basic exam, NEET, which gives entrance to all these courses. Yeah, so this was...
Okay. Oh, that's very precise and to the point. Thank you. Moving on, when did you decide you'll opt for core astrophysics and not any other so-called mother fields of engineering? That goes to Maitre, I guess, because having scored 97% in 10th standard and being so good already at physics and mathematics,
finally we are able anyone to would have recommended Sachin sir.
Yeah,
finally
we I wasn't visible to you all this time.
No.
Okay. I'm so sorry. Okay, so Maitre, why did you opt for astrophysics and not any other so-called mother fields of engineering?
Okay, so I'd like to correct you. I didn't score 97. I scored 95. So, like, ऐसा लोगों को ऐसा ज़्यादा मत बताओ.
तो तभी best of five नहीं था क्या तभी?
नहीं था. Best of five से 95
था. अच्छा, I guess Maithili scored 97.
Yeah, I guess, yeah.
Yeah. You live in the same building, I suppose. नहीं, same school.
Yeah. नहीं, same building also. But let's get back to the question. So my first exposure to astrophysics or I would say the concept of astronomy was like around first or second standard, because there used to be a book fair in my school, and like I was really drawn to one of the books, and it was just about planets and stuff. And I guess it just went on increasing, like the fascination just turned into a hobby, the hobby turned into a passion, and now I would like to continue that passion into my career option. But yeah, it was not like easy, because when I was in the second grade, like my parents were not at all interested in allowing me to like pursuing a degree or pursuing a career in astrophysics, because like they didn't know much about that. All that I knew was like, all they knew was through like reading books and stuff, because like there was very less internet back then, and it was really difficult for us to like know how to do it. But right now, it's very easy for people. Like, if anyone's interested in any other fields, like not astrophysics, but like for you guys, it's very easy to learn more about that stuff, and you know, get just know how you can enter that field as a career.
You also did have a telescope, I guess, at your place, right?
Yeah, I mean that was pretty late. I bought them in the second grade, but yeah, okay. I joined an amateur astronomer organization. It's in Kalyan. They are called Akash Mitra Mandal. Right now they're not meeting because of the virus, but they played a crucial part in, you know, like they taught me how to handle telescopes. And astronomy is one thing and astrophysics is one thing. Like when the word physics comes in, there's just tons of math involved in that. So they were the guys who introduced the math to me. So like, yeah, you just need like proper context, and you should know what you need to learn to like understand what you need to do.
Okay. Thanks a lot. I also say here that all the students who are already on the panel, I mean the speakers as well as the students, in case some students wants to get in touch with you directly, any of the speakers, I'll be sharing your contact numbers even without asking you. So just help out with them. Okay. So moving on, this question is for Ritesh again. What sets the IIT class apart from other engineering institutes in the country? Like, why is that craze so much? What is so different about IIT? Ritesh.
Yeah, so I think so there are actually many things. So some of the things are very directly visible. So you can see that most people want to pursue or engineering at IIT because they pay well. So after you complete your engineering degree, you get a fairly good job. And another thing is that almost everybody gets the job. So that's actually very a very distinguishing quality of IIT, because there are very few colleges in India which can give give a placement to everybody, whoever is entering into, what irrespective of their discipline, whatever engineering they pursue. So So the very interesting thing about the TechFest and Mood Indigo is that these are actually Asia's, I mean, if not Asia, at least India's largest cultural festival and technology festival, respectively. And these are fully managed by students. So in order to conduct such a festival as such a big kind, you need to have a very good organizational skill, you need to have very good marketing skill, and you need to have very good managerial skill. And all these skills, I think, you can either get it in an MBA college or you can get it by doing. So that's what I think sets apart another one more thing that IITs are different in, because you get to explore this thing and you need to get to learn those skills by actually doing things, by actually organizing events. And I think that's also one very good benefit that you get in IIT.
So there's a story that I remember, I'll just add on to this with Ritesh. Roman and Ritesh had a friend in common who did not have very good grades in his engineering semesters, BTech semesters, but he was at a leading position in Mood Indigo management team.
Yeah.
He was bringing a lot of marketing and is bringing a lot of revenue. So he brought a lot of sponsorship. So there was another company which had a different percentage criteria, which he did not qualify for. But just because he managed Mood Indigo and he had such a lot of experience, huge amount of experience for back-to-back 4 years of managing Mood Indigo, he got through the job, actually got through the job, right? And he got a good package also. So that is also what IIT sets it apart. It can also offer you a job with a handsome package, which is not even from your own core field. It is something from your own skill set, right?
Yes, I think.
Okay, so that is something.
There are many cases actually where people have just in fact, my grades are not that good. So and I am currently working in financial services industry. So that actually tells that you can do anything, and that actually is very helpful for people who enter into IIT and explore different things. Yeah.
In fact, one of our common professors, Hitesh Moge, was into the cultural sector of IIT Bombay, and he was known for his acting across all IITs in India, something like that, right?
Yeah,
so it gives you a good platform to on your skills a lot. Okay, thank you, Hitesh. Why US and not other countries in abroad education, Vasudev? Why is US preferred a lot?
Okay, so this is a bit trick question. So I would definitely not, 100% advocate going to US based on what is happening right now in US. People are just they are absurdly protesting against not wearing masks and everything. I mean, that's not something that we have, what we think when we leave from India, it's going to be like this and it's going to be party and everything like that. But it's really not exactly what we have that picture in our mind. That's the reality over here. The other thing, I mean, why US is more popular and why not the other countries? I would second what Harsh said or Maitreya said about this, is basically you have many more opportunities while you are studying here. It's not like you have to. So I'm in civil engineering right now, but it's not really necessary for me in order to get civil engineering that you should take these courses only. I can explore different courses. If I want to take any economics course, like Maitreya said, I can go ahead and take it. If I want to take some maths course or maybe some physics or astrophysics course or maybe aerospace engineering course, I can go ahead and take it. There's not a barrier that holds you. It's just the requirement that there are certain number of courses in your 10 courses that you have to take in order to get a particular degree. If I'm taking civil engineering, there has to be at least 8 courses that, confine my knowledge to civil engineering. But yeah, there are many other opportunities. Then there are research opportunities also, you can work under a professor, and it pays well also, while you are studying, it does pay also. It has huge amount of exposure to research as well as, professors and how to write papers and how to do research and everything like that. So yeah, that's one thing about US. The other thing about US is, like Hirsch said, while going to other countries like Germany or maybe any other country in Europe or maybe Russia or something like that, there are language barriers. So if you go to Germany or if you go to Belgium or any other country like Netherlands or something, there are language barriers. So you have to learn their language first in order to gain the education over there. But in US, it's not, there is no, not a huge language barrier. The next thing is, it's relatively hard to get into US because there are visa issues and everything. But once you get in, it's, I wouldn't say a cakewalk, but it's really easier to, you know, survive in US because more than, I think, like, what US, like 2 years in US or maybe not right now, maybe 3 years in US has taught me is it's not basically on how smart you are in the class, but how street smart you are in the class. It's about more about communication skills to get the jobs or, you know, ace something or maybe stand out from the crowd. It's more about your communication skills rather than your technical skills. So a person can be, you know, kind of average scoring guy, but if his communication skills are well, his people skills are well, he can easily survive in US because that's what is important while you get a job. And yeah, that's more like it. And it's not a big issue, but what I think is there is less culture shock. Like there is a thing called culture shock. Like when you move from India to some other country or some other place, there's a culture, even in India, like if you move from state to state, we have different cultures. So there's basically a culture shock. Like people do some things differently in different cultures. So once you come to US, there's a less culture shock because there is a lot of Indian population. There are a lot of Indian students around you. There are a lot of Indian restaurants, whatever, like Indian institutes and everything. So you can go ahead and, you know, enroll yourself in the societies and everything and interact with people here. So there is a less of culture shock. So that's why I feel US is more preferable than any other countries. But one second, I said, I wouldn't strongly advocate coming to US. There are pretty much better countries, like there's Canada, or maybe you can go to Australia or New Zealand. Yeah, even UK is pretty much better. But their economic situation is not good right now. But anyway, the thing is, that's why I would say like US is better than any other countries, the reasons I gave.
Okay. Vasudev, while talking about this question, mentioned survival. So let me tell you all, Vasudev is a hardcore Malwani. Okay, so fish is something that is 24/7 on his mind. So I would request Vasudev to put light on that also. Like, how do you manage like food and all? You cook, right?
Yes, I do cook. So mostly I cook for 2 days and then I, you know, put it like in bowls or something and keep it like refrigerated or something like that, and then I eat it afterwards. But on weekends generally I cook like really good food. So let me tell you one thing, I am a hardcore non-vegetarian. So hardly one day goes in a week that I don't eat meat.
Okay.
Otherwise, there's always chicken.
I just purposely popped on that question to mention my students that if you want to plan, if you wish to plan to go to abroad, other countries, you must have some basic living skills in you that would not make you drain financially.
No, it's really not a matter of living skills because you have ovens over here, so you can just bring chicken breast from your local grocery store. You just put it in the pan and throw it in the oven for 12 minutes. That's
okay, done. So maybe we are going to more of Khana Khazana.
You don't have to have like Gordon Ramsay skills or maybe Sanjeev Kapoor skills to survive in.
Okay.
It's just
okay.
A matter of, you know, you're good with the...
Fine. Going ahead, what is the most followed or looked up to medical field doctors aspire to get into? Maitre, Harsh Agarwal. Like there are many medical fields out there, but which one is the most looked up to or followed or, you know, the dream medical field to get into for doctors?
So actually what happens is the different mindsets which makes somebody to go for a particular stream. So like people who are who want less patient interaction, like they don't want to interact with the patient more, so they opt for the microbiology or pathology or biochemistry part. Then there are some people who want to have the joy of surgery, so they go for general surgery or orthopedic surgery. Or there are some people who are more interested in serving the people, getting idea about what is going on in the country, what all cases are there, infections and all. So they go for general medicine, and it requires more working hours also. It requires a lot of reading, a lot of fat books you have to read, and there are some which you require a lot of precision, like in ENT surgery. Or in ophthalmology, you require a lot of precision. It's very tiny thing you have to do. You have to work in very tiny things. And the most beloved or the most and yet the most difficult one is to get in is the radiology. Because the amount you get after getting a radiology degree, specialization degree, is very big. And the compared to that, the efforts you have to go you have to do for a radiologist, being a radiologist, is much lesser. Like you have to be at the clinic and go for the reports, and you have to not do much stuff, but still you get a good fat amount of money. So doctors really look up to going for a radiology degree, but it's the best one people opt for, and it's really very difficult to get into. You have to be in the top thousands in the country to get a radiology seat.
Okay. Just one more query, a common man query from medical field. How relevant is this Russia drug right now, brother, on corona?
Russia drug, actually, it's not...
The one we are hearing of on News 24/7 right now.
Yeah. They have prepared a vaccine. So unless the vaccine, their sample or the Russian sample comes to India and we test the sample, we cannot approve, the ICMR cannot approve to give it to the Indians. So first the sample should be drawn from Russia to India. It should be tested whether it is live attenuated vaccine or it's killed vaccine, what is the genre of the vaccine. And then ICMR will certify it and prescribe it to the Indians. Until now, it's like they have made a breaking news. Like Russia has made a breaking news breakthrough in the coronavirus, but still we have not we are not very sure like how it's working.
So it's like fingers crossed and still hopeful.
They are correct, and we hope the sample which is drawn in India, which will be drawn in India, make good results in India. Because the pattern, the health of their people and health of our people is different. Like sir said that I'm a hardcore non-vegetarian. I eat fish every day. Does Indian people will able to survive with that vaccine which they have made? So that is the point of debate here.
Correct. Okay, thank you. The next question is, what entrances are you supposed to appear to go for a course after 10 plus 2? How to prepare, when to start? That's for Maitreya. So he went to US after 10 plus 2 to pursue his bachelor's in astrophysics. So I want Maitreya to put some light on ते कोणत्या परीक्षा असतात आणि कधी सुरू करायचं आणि कसं कसं प्रिपरेशन कसं करायचं.
Okay, so the short answer to this question is every university, every college in the US has different criteria for admission, but there are some tests that you have to give because you are not from the US. So there's this you have to appear for like two major categorized tests. First, the first tests are termed like termed as standardized tests, and the second one is to prove you are proficient in English, so you can like understand what they teach you there. So it really depends on what college you want to go to. So you might need to do your research on that. But most of the colleges in the US accept SAT and ACT. It's different. Like the pronunciation is really difficult, but you can just email me, I'll give you all the details. But these two, they generally have English and maths as their base. And I personally appeared for the SAT, which is like a 1600 point exam. And like around a score around 1100 or above is generally a good sign of like you will get into one of the more prestigious colleges. And for English proficiency, mine was 1330. Yeah. And for English proficiency, I appeared for TOEFL, which is fairly easy. It's just a computerized test. And you have to just let them know that you are like proficient in English. You can speak English, you can write English, you can read English. And it's a 120-point exam. And anywhere around 80, like more than 80 to 85, it's a fine score. But I would also say that this score pe sab depend nahi hota. Because the universities in the US don't just look for academics. They also look at your other things than academics. Like for me, being a part of the astronomy club in India was a major boost up in my ranking or grading, if you want to say that. So, yeah. And I don't think like 12th score matters really, because for me, I submitted them my mark sheets from 9th through 11th grade. And for the question, when did I start? So I appeared for the SAT when I was in 11th grade. So I like, you don't need much time to prepare for the exam. It's fairly easy. Like people will tell you to join coaching classes and stuff, but they're like too expensive and you don't really need that. For SAT or TOEFL, they have books for that. Like you can buy books from their official website and you can use the books. It's not that difficult.
Okay.
Hey, if I want to ask Maitreya this, if I'm not wrong, I guess most of the universities for this year and next year, they have waived SAT and GRE, right?
Yeah, they have waived them. Yeah. Because like, I don't think the SAT was done this year.
Yeah. So anyone who wants to join, like come to US this year, you have pretty good option. Yeah, you just need to fill out the applications. Like, yeah.
Yeah, some of my friends who are from UAE, like they're Indian, but they stay in the UAE. They didn't give SAT or anything. They just used their 11th and 12th scores to get into the US. So yeah. It just depends. Like I would just suggest you to like look, just find a college that's appropriate for your degree, that like you can use that college. Like basically, yeah, you can just use that college's prerequisites, and I can help you with that. Like just shoot me an email.
Okay. Thank you, Maitreya. We'll go ahead with the next question, which is, what field are you working currently in and why did you choose it? That is straight away to Ritesh, because its field currently is completely different from what it did in IIT. So Ritesh, atta sadhya tujhi kai field hai jethu kaam karto hai ani tu tya field la ka manun gelas? Why did you choose that?
Okay, so currently I'm working in financial services industry. So I think finance and economics is what touches everyone actually, because we deal with money, we have bank accounts, we take mortgages and everything. I mean, so in that sense it touches everything, but so I am working in particularly a subfield which is known as financial modeling, and where if I want to explain it in a layman's term, it would be like we use mathematics and statistics to predict what would happen to any bank or any financial institution in a near-term future. So that's what we broadly do. And I think the question whether like, why did I choose it? I think that's more to do with my readings actually. So one thing which I have inculcated in me is diverse reading habits actually. So when I was at IIT, I used to read quite a lot about different issues actually. So whether it is history, whether it is civilization, culture, and economics more importantly. And while reading in economics, I actually got interested in that. I wanted to know actually how the economic theories are, how do they work, and how those theories translate into the policies that we currently see. So you might hear currently that we are in an economic crisis, that government needs to do these things. Everybody is saying something like we need to do this, we need to do that. So these are actually very interesting questions, and how to solve these questions, how to answer these questions. So these curiosities, it just piled up in my mind, and then I decided to do, while I was working in software industry, I decided to pursue a degree, a master's degree in economics. So, and I chose to do that. And after that, yeah, I'm now currently working in financial services industry, which is completely different from engineering actually.
Okay, just to give you a small insight on Ritesh's early life, like when we had a group and used to hang around in 11th and 12th, he was pretty poor at finances. Like we used to always eat stuff and make Ritesh pay and never pay him back. So it's kind of revenge time for him. His earning bucks across India just because his friends did not let him do good in finances that time. Okay, moving ahead. Thank you, Ritesh. The next question is, what should a student aiming to be a doctor do right from his class 10 so as to ensure his seat in one of the most reputed colleges across the country? Let's say, for example, AIIMS or JIPMER. So, abhi agar main 10th mein hoon aur mujhe bahut bade institute se doctor banna hai, to mujhe is samay kya shuru karna chahiye? Mere habits kya hone chahiye? Mera reading habits kya hona chahiye? Mujhe kis tarah se approach karna chahiye? Aur जैसे डिसिप्लिन की बात हितेश ने की, तो मेडिकल प्रोफेशन के लिए क्या डिसिप्लिन मेंटेन करना चाहिए?
हर्ष, जैसे 10th स्टैंडर्ड इज एक्चुअली अर्ली, लाइक वी आर येट, लाइक यू सेड, वी आर डूइंग दिस टीचिंग ऑफ 3 आवर्स, यू आर गोइंग फॉर एडवांस्ड फिजिक्स, दैट इज वेरी गुड, बट वी आर डूइंग गुड स्टफ, बट एक्चुअली गोइंग फॉर द प्रिपरेशन इज, सो वी हैव टू गो फॉर बेसिक प्रिपरेशन, लाइक वी हैव टू इंक्रीज आवर मेमोरी. Like by increasing memory, I don't mean to say ki you eat walnuts or eat almonds. Like you have to play memory games. Like there are memory games. You go search on internet. What are the memory games which increases your power to memorize more words, more formulas. Like there are one of my friend. Like you say him 100 words and he'll repeat you 100 words in the same pattern.
Okay.
So it increases the power of remembering more words at a time. Then there is a technique of learning of making flashcards.
Okay.
People make flashcards. They make mnemonics. So how to make flashcards, you have to learn. So with one word given, you can memorize the whole chapter. Like you give the title and you can memorize the whole chapter. This is the flashcard technique. And increase vocabulary, read good books or whatever stuff you read, which gives you new words, more vocabulary, because English words in medicine are very much apart from the layman words.
Okay.
We use a word prevention normally, but in medicine we use not prevention, but we use prophylaxis. So the words are very different. Then concentrate on more working hours, like to more sit and more study. Like you have to non-stop sit for 4-5 hours. So for that, like there is a web series on YouTube. Many of us would have seen it. Quota Factory.
So
Quota Factory deals with lot of pressure techniques. Like hum bolenge to bachcho ko lekar kya lecture de raha hai. But jab wo as a film dekhte hain, to the student really connects with the character of the Vaibhav Pandey in the Quota Factory.
Correct.
So it really moves you. Then going through the scientific concepts of maths and science really thoroughly. So when you go for the MCQ part, the small concepts you don't need to look for again and again. Ki acha iska kya matlab hai yaar? Pehle 10th standard ka book kholte hain. To wo karna nahi padega aapko. Then acquiring a good percentage or pointer, whatever is applicable, is very important, as well as in 10th and 12th for medicine. Like sirs said that ki 10th ka percentage itna bhi mayne rakhta hai, but agar hamara marks agar entrance mein same aata hai do logo ka, jo ki bahut commonly hota hai ki do logo ka marks same aa raha hai, so they go for the 12th ka marks and they go for the 10th ka marks.
The tie breaking for a seat in America,
tie breaking for a seat is 10th and first 12th and then 10th ka marks. So it's very really important to go for it. And after 10th, you have to don't waste time. Take classes quickly, like beforehand, before you give the finals or immediately as you give finals, you should have a admission letter of the coaching class which you wish to join for 11th and 12th, and make sure that it gives the integrated college ka option because it really saves too much time. At least 5 hours a day it saves you, and which is very important to solve MCQs, do your stuff, very much important. So these are few steps you should
have
follow.
It for 3 years now.
Yeah, we have with Royal College, I think.
No, we have with SV Joshi College.
Achha.
That's more of professional and good.
My time it was Royal College.
It was Royal College. Thanks, Harsh. So what Harsh said is just like engineering relies on the foundation of logic building, medicine relies on the logic of information collection. There's a lot of information to remember, collect, and also apply from time to time. So you need to be good at memorizing things and in a very systematic way. Ratta marna nahi bol raha hai Harsh yahan pe. We bol raha hai ki we have to conceptually memorize things and at the same time accumulate everything and be able to apply whenever it is required, right?
Yes.
Okay. So moving ahead, this is again to Vasudev. He was into singing, martial arts. He's also one of the RealMness founders members. How important, Vasudev, do you think it is to groom yourself beyond academics? Life mein, padhai ke alawa aur groom karna khud ko kitna zaruri hai?
Okay, so like I told, so Sachin ne abhi tak mere bare mein jitna bhi kuch bataya rahega, like I was a scholar student, I was basically not. I was better than average. I wasn't like really scholar student. Like I used to have 95% or something like that, or maybe 10 point or 9 point or something like that. I used to have reasonably good marks, but the thing is, when you are doing, like you are pursuing your academics, basically, it's not really important to, you know, just focus on academics. And you have to have your, like, if you have taken science, there's a general notion that you have to have a book 24 hours in your hand, even when you are going to sleep. Like my mother used to tell me these stories about one of my uncles, like one of her brothers. He was from Sardar Patel College of Engineering, and he used to have like a really fat disc. Like he's also a civil engineer. He's also a structural engineer. And she used to tell me, like, when we were like kids, he used to have like this big fat book of some civil engineering or something in his hand. And he used to read his even when he used to go to sleep. It's not really important to do that. I tell you first thing, it's really important to know your concepts, your basic concepts. You should be able to, you know, so what I have, there's a difference between learning patterns. There's a huge difference between learning patterns in India and in US. In India, it's basically that your learning pattern is basically based on how much you can memorize. And in US, it's basically based on how much you can actually apply, like whatever you have learned. So India mein aisa chal jata hai ki are yaar main ye cheez, like you have a set question paper pattern set. So उसमें चल जाता है कि अरे ये मैं ऑप्शन में डाल दूंगा, लेकिन यहाँ पे ऑप्शन में डाल के नहीं चलता है, बिकॉज ऐसा नहीं है ना कि कोई भी बिल्डिंग कॉलम के बिना नहीं बनता. अगर मैंने कॉलम ऑप्शन में डाला है तो बिल्डिंग खड़ा ही नहीं होगा कभी. सो दैट्स रियली इंपॉर्टेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट यू शुड बी एबल टू गेट योर ग्राफ्स, योर कॉन्सेप्ट्स फर्स्ट. द सेकंड थिंग इज अबाउट एक्स्ट्रा करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज व्हाइल डूइंग योर एकेडमिक्स. इज व्हाई दे आर इंपॉर्टेंट इज इट डजंट, you know, confine your knowledge to just a book. Like you should be able to tell your, it's not, I wouldn't say success stories, but you should be having a wide range of experiences. Like you should have people connect. Like I said, you should be street smart rather than being just book smart, because street smart people can deal with any situation. Agar bande ko ek question pucha, agar usko answer bhi aata nahi, तो वो टाइम के लिए वो कुछ ना कुछ बहाना निकाल के वो वक्त पास कर लेगा. बट इफ यू आस्क दिस टू बुक अ बुक स्मार्ट पर्सन, ही वुड जस्ट पैनिक एंड ही वुड गो हेवायर. सो दैट्स व्हाई एक्स्ट्रा करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज एंड पीपल कनेक्ट इज मच मोर इम्पोर्टेंट. आई हैव बीन इनटू लाइक सचिन सेड, आई हैव बीन इनटू लाइक वाइड रेंज ऑफ एक्स्ट्रा करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज. सो मोर देन लाइक आई स्टडी माई सेल्फ, आई स्टडी हार्डली अराउंड 3 to 4 hours per day. But yeah, it's really important. Like when I study, I don't have anything else in my mind. So when I study, it's 100% study. And any other time, like I have done like singing, then I've done martial arts, and like I've been founding member, then I have been 2 times in core team, and two years. I guess I'm still trustee, right?
Yeah, you are.
Am I or am I? Yeah, okay.
You are a trustee.
So still I'm a trustee of RealMness. So it's not really about, you know, how well you can, you know, answer a particular question. It's really important, like how well you can, you have prepared yourself and you can present yourself in front of people. And I feel like doing this all other stuff grooms your personality to a level that you can present yourself to others in a better sense. Like I said, you should be able to tell something to your kids when you grow up. Like, yeah, I did this and I did that. And not just I scored maybe how much? 1400 in SATs or 330 or 340 in GRE. It's not really important. Like those numbers are not going to matter in a certain future. But yeah, it is what you feel that's going to be important for you. And you should be targeting, like you should be focusing to achieve that goal of good marks and everything. But yeah, these things are also important. But that doesn't also mean like you are at the stage, like for 10th and 12th students especially, it's not like extracurricular activities important hai, but not at this point when you have your exams and everything. Like अगर मैंने बोला है कि एक्स्ट्रा करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज है तो घर पे तुम लोग बोलोगे कि नहीं अभी मैं हम लोग बाहर गाना गाने के लिए जा रहे हैं या खेलने के लिए जा रहे हैं. दैट्स नॉट रियली इम्पोर्टेंट राइट नाउ. डू वॉट एवर इज इम्पोर्टेंट इन दैट मोमेंट. लाइक इट डजंट हैव टू बी लाइक एवरी टाइम यू आर डूइंग समथिंग ओनली वन थिंग एंड नॉट फोकसिंग ऑन. देयर शुड बी अ बैलेंस ऑलवेज.
Correct. Okay. So what Vasudev said, I'll sum it up in one more way, that whatever degree you pursue, whatever subject you study, life doesn't bring upon situations and questions just on that. Okay. It is many times beyond that. It is many times beyond things that you have never read about. And it is always good to explore that boundary of what you can learn up to. Someone somewhere said, he's a very famous person. I don't remember him. I'll just quote him just like he said. He said, don't let your schooling spoil your learning. Okay, so your learning does not depend on the curriculum, the periods, the syllabus. It depends on what actually you look up to. Let's take up is Mahendra Singh Dhoni. So Dhoni retired yesterday. What I read of Dhoni's career entirely, that he was the first guy in international cricket who could bring up the idea that cricket is also a mind game. Like you can think about, you can be spontaneous, you can be witty and just change the entire game. One. Point number two. He was never a textbook player, like just like Tendulkar or Rohit Sharma or any other Ren Lara or any other textbook batsman. He was never that. He invented his own shots. But what matters at the end is what he has achieved, right? So do dare to go beyond books. Do dare to hone your skills as much as you can. And then,
I read this like really good article around a week ago about there's a bridge in US called. There's a river called, and right now the situation is like that's the probably the most sturdiest bridge US has ever built. Like it can take up to a level 6 or level 7 hurricane in maybe coming future. But the thing right now is after building that bridge, after around 6 months after a particular bridge, there was a huge hurricane in that region, and that hurricane actually changed the flow of the river. So now instead of running under the river running under the bridge, now it runs a slightly away from the bridge. So there's just land below the bridge right now, and there's a river that's running next to bridge. There's no water under the bridge. So now that bridge is something what we call like that bridge leads to nowhere. So what I think is this extracurricular, like what lesson we can take from basically that particular bridge is that no matter how well you are prepared for any other situation, if you don't change yourself with respect to coming time and adapt skills and, you know, groom yourself, like nobody knew like 6 months ago that we are going to have, you know, like this virtual kind of meetings and everything. But now today we are doing, you know, like obsolete thing, and people will be just communicating through this virtual platforms. So that is more important.